It's a training video for a 7 series field hookup using a Powermaster to test it with. When you first come up to your test switches, the first thing you want to do is identify your voltages and your currents. As you can see, this is a form 9S meter. We have 3-phase voltage, 3-phase current. The current, if you will notice, has the returns jumper together with neutral. So that's how you can identify which direction current is flowing. You will also notice on the current that there is 2 switches. One will short the secondary of the CT, which is the one you want to pull first, and then the second one you want to open and insert the ductbills.
Once you've identified your service type and your meter form and where you're going to make your connections, the next thing you want to do is go into your software and create your site and set up the Powermaster to begin testing. If you're not familiar with how to do this, be sure and either watch the video online or read the user manual. To test this site effectively, you only need to fill out these fields. Create a site ID, select your meter form, in this case it's a 9, select your service, in this case 4-wire Y, your service type, 3-phase, 4-wire Y, 3 voltage, 3 current transformers, test setup, either create one or select one you've already created, and enter your case of T. Be sure and save this and then select this site, and at that point you should be ready to begin your testing of the form. The next step is to begin your secondary connections as a test switch. You're going to connect phase A, B, and C voltages along with neutral to their respective tabs. And then you're going to shunt the test switches for your CTs. Open the connections that your CTs are going to go into, your ductbill CTs. And then once they are inserted into the test switches, then you're going to reclose your shunts. This will allow current to begin to flow again. Be sure that with your ductbill CTs that current is flowing into the white side and returns from the black side. Typically this will mean white side up, but in very rare occasions it has been seen that something will be wired backwards and you will have to flip them. But for the most part it's white side up, black side down. The next step is to locate and make our connections for our primary current measurements. In this case it is a pad mounted transformer. Observe all your safety requirements before entering or working inside an energized transformer. Once the transformer is opened, locate your phase A, B, and C. Connect your flexuring cable around all cables that are going through the CT for that particular phase. Phase A, B, and C should all be connected. The arrow on each flex ring should be pointing towards the load. This will help verify correct phasor alignment and also correct power calculations. After you finish making your connections, verify that you do have your IR probe on the front of the meter. Then you can take a look at your vectors, your harmonics, your digital multimeter. Verify everything looks okay, then proceed with your integrated site test option, which is detailed on how to operate this in the user manual and the additional training videos online. Once your test is finished and you have verified that everything is correct and you're satisfied with the results, be sure and save your results. Disconnect your primary CTs. Shunt your secondary CTs. Remove your ductbills. Reclose in those test switches. Reclose your shunts. Verify that current's flowing again on the front panel of the meter. Remove your voltage connections, power off your unit, remove auxiliary power, and finally, remove ground.